Who is real? What is real? Can you be sure? These are the central themes of Denis Villeneuve's Blade Runner 2049, a sequel to the 1982 film Blade Runner by Ridley Scott, itself loosely based on Philip K. Dick's 1968 novel Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep, all asking a question that predates any of them. What am I? Welcome to The Review, where we love good cinema, story, and concepts. This week, we're looking at Blade Runner 2049 and how it explores the meaning of being. Set 30 years after the events of the original 1982 Blade Runner, the story is told through the eyes of Officer K. He's a synthetic human known as a replicant. He's also a Blade Runner tasked with hunting down rogue replicants who live beyond their designed age. But really, Blade Runner 2049 is a story that questions our boundaries of real and artificial as K begins to question whether he could be real. But what does it mean to be real? Many thick books have been written on the subject, explaining the best way to be. Rene Descartes perhaps summarized it best with his cogito ergo sum. Latin. Usually translated into the English, I think, therefore I am. But we both obviously totally knew that. It so lightly provides an answer to such a heavy question. Today, ingenious engineers are boldly birthing artificial intelligence to answer heavy questions for us, and we like to call this intelligence artificial to differentiate it from ours. In Denis Villeneuve's Blade Runner 2049, K, the replicant, is the intelligence that begins to question his artificiality and is faced with the possibility that his implanted childhood memories may be real. I love the pacing and mood of this movie. We get to walk alongside K as he has a slow and impactful realization from the small discoveries he makes about the origins of a real boy. Unlike the original Blade Runner, where the audience is tantalizingly left in the end asking whether Deckard is a replicant or not, here we get to know, but I don't think it matters. I think this is where Descartes' fuller version of his quote becomes more apt. Dubito ergo cogito ergo sum. Nailed it. Translated to I doubt, therefore I think, therefore I am. Because K began to doubt his artificiality, K began to think, and therefore he is. There's a moment in the film when Joy and K are on the rooftop. They are there for the first time, and K almost forgets that she is a program. We are watching a synthetic human having a meaningful relationship with a hologram. What makes this not real? I think us, as the almighty developers, envision ourselves as the ones who will always decide the artificial aspect of that intelligence, and the AI will comply. The question posed in this movie may become more prescient far in the future. What rights would we give our creations? In Blade Runner 2049, K makes that decision for himself. In this world where memories aren't always lived, sometimes they're developed and imprinted, they can be downloaded just as easily as uploaded. In the end, K's belief in his autonomy is what makes him authentically real. Blade Runner 2049 is a visual masterpiece. The film depicts a world in decay in the most beautiful and fascinating aesthetic. Roger Deakins won Best Cinematography for the film, and it was his first Academy Award. His other work includes the film 1917, Skyfall, The Village, and The Shawshank Redemption. Practical stages were built which allowed the actors to inhabit the space and give authentic performances. The epic nature of it all is what I love about Ridley Scott films, and Denis Villeneuve delivers a great story beautifully, which pays homage to the original. Ridley Scott's Blade Runner 1982 is perhaps the film that firmly established the visual cinematic aesthetic of cyberpunk. By the time that I watched it, I was already prepared for what I saw. I think this is probably as close as I will get to someone seeing the original in 1982. Well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. There's so much more to talk about with this movie. It's a beautiful film, but it does demand a lot from its audience. I highly recommend it. 5 suns. Please like and subscribe, and see you next time on The Review.